Okay, for today's session, I will start from this subsection, which is determining the values of component in the transformer model. So this subsection actually fall under the 2.5, which is equivalent circuit of the transformer. Okay, so actually for the transformer, in order for us to represent the transformer in terms of equivalent circuit model, okay, what we do is we conduct the experiment lah. We conduct the experiment to determine the values of the transformer. Okay, to determine the values of the transformer, and then the values of the inductances and resistance of the transformer model itu, kita boleh conduct experiment. And then actually what we do is we just do the approximation, not necessarily what we do is something that is exactly the same as the real value, but actually we do the assumption as well. And then for that approximation of the transformer values, we can calculate, we can represent the transformer in terms of model, and then do the calculation of the transformer values lah, and then study about the transformer behavior. Okay, what we do is to conduct the open circuit test. Okay, we conduct the open circuit test.
Here is some information for how to perform open circuit test. According to Circuit Globe, open circuit test. The wattmeter, ammeter, and the voltage are connected to their primary.
Okay. Dia nak cakap pula. Okay, what we do is we do the open circuit test and then the short circuit test. Okay, the short circuit test. So remember two methods that can be done in order for us to determine the values of the transformer model. Values of the transformer model maksudnya RS, RP, XS, XP, XM, RC kan. Semua value-value tu kita boleh determine menggunakan open circuit test and also the short circuit test. So now I will go through one by one, start from the open circuit test, okay? So, in open circuit test, the circuit configuration is something like this, okay? This is the primary side, okay? Bahagian ini adalah primary side lah. Yang selepas pada transformer ni, ada secondary side lah, which is load side. So in this circuit configuration, as you can see clearly, at the secondary side, we let it open circuit. Okay, maksudnya at this terminal, we do not connect any loads. We do not connect any loads at this terminal, at the output terminal of the transformer. So this is what we call as the open circuit test lah. Okay. So this is what we call open circuit test, okay? In order to determine the values of the transformer, okay? So in open circuit test, basically we want to determine the parallel branch component. Okay, maksudnya open circuit test itu kita buat, kita nak determine parallel branch component. RC, XM ni. Contoh, untuk circuit ni, RC dengan XM lah. Okay. So, in open circuit test, what we basically do is to determine the RC dengan XM. Okay. And then we have another, which is short circuit test. We will go discussing about short circuit test later. But basically, for the short circuit test, we want to determine the series branch component, series component lah, like REQ and XEQ, for example. Okay, so clear, open circuit test kita nak determine apa? Kita nak determine the excitation branch punya values. Short circuit test, we want to determine the series component values. Okay. So what we do is we do the arrangement like this, and then we supply the input current. We supply the input current. Maknanya kita supply current lah daripada source ini. Kita supply current. Kita supply current kepada transformer itu, which is the current that will be flowing through the excitation branch, okay? Excitation branch of the transformer. And then we can determine the series element, which is RP, XP. And then we can determine the RC and XM, which is the excitation branch punya component, in which actually we assume that RP and XP ini cukup-cukup kecil, in which we can just neglect the RP and XP so that we can determine RC and XM, which is the excitation branch lah, parallel branch punya. Okay, so we apply the full line voltage. Full line voltage maksudnya ni, kita daripada voltage source ini kita adjust kepada maximum voltage. Kita adjust pada maximum voltage so that voltage drop berlaku dekat excitation branch sahaja. Okay, excitation branch sahaja. Voltage drop berlaku dekat RC dengan XM sahaja. Pada RP dengan XP, too small. Okay, maksudnya bila kita buat open circuit macam ni, open circuit, of course lah, series punya voltage drop tak ada lah sebab dia open circuit. Okay, series punya voltage drop tak ada. Semua current akan melalui transformer ni. Semua current akan melalui transformer dan patah balik dekat primary. Okay, dekat primary. So, current tu akan berada dekat primary dan patah balik. So, voltage drop berlaku dekat primary saja. So, dekat secondary tak ada voltage drop lah. That is why from there we can determine RC and XM at the primary side. Okay. So, once we have done with the full line voltage applied to the transformer primary side, and then after that we can measure. Bila kita dah letak adjust sehingga full line voltage, so at that moment we can record the value of voltage through the voltmeter. We can record the value of current using the ammeter here, and then also the power values lah using the wattmeter. Okay, so we have current in ampere, voltage open circuit in volt, current open circuit in ampere, and then power open circuit in watt. So kita ada tiga values ni. POC, IOC, and then VOC. Okay. Then menggunakan POC, IOC, and VOC itu, we can use that values to determine the excitation admittance ini. Kita menggunakan value tadi untuk determine the excitation admittance, so that by using this excitation admittance we can further calculate to determine the conductance and also the susceptance. Bila kita dah determine the conductance and susceptance, barulah kita dapat determine dia punya RC dengan XM. Okay, so saya ulang ah, saya ulang, kita buat full line voltage test. Okay, full line voltage test, kita adjust voltage tu. Okay, dan biarkan bahagian secondary side ini open circuit. Okay, so current akan mengalir pada primary side sahaja, dan pada masa tu, semasa full line voltage tu applied to that transformer, we calculate lah daripada meter kan, daripada meter we just record the value of VOC, IOC and POC. Okay, once we get the value of VOC, IOC and POC, kita boleh determine admittance lah. Kita boleh determine admittance. Okay, menggunakan value tadi, IOC bahagi dengan VOC kita dapat admittance. Theta ni sebenarnya kita determine daripada menggunakan P. Okay. That's why kita measure tiga-tiga. Kita measure power, voltage and current in order for us to determine cosine theta, which is power factor of the transformer. Once we get cosine theta, then we can determine the theta. Okay. Once we get theta, then we can determine YE, which is admittance. Itu step dia lah. Okay. So, that is the explanation secara teori. Okay. Nak mudah faham lagi, I will recommend for you to follow tutorial 2.2, which is based on the example 2.2. Okay, follow that tutorial. Saya ada upload dah tutorial tu eh. Dalam Google Classroom pun ada. Bukan Google Classroom. Manalah? Sekejap lah, saya nak tunjuk. It is easier for you to go to the class eh. Google site, kelas Google site, pergi kepada recorded tutorial video ni, terus kat sini saja. Kalau pergi cari dekat YouTube channel, maybe susah nak jumpa. Tutorial 2.2 ada sedikit description lah, ada sedikit description and some correction to that tutorial. So you can follow this tutorial to further understand on how we can use the short circuit test and the open circuit test to determine the transformer values in terms of impedances to represent the transformer model. Okay. Okay. So, the short circuit test, sorry, the open circuit test is basically we want to determine the YE. YE. What we do is to determine the YE is by based on the open circuit test. Okay, untuk mana dah tadi? Untuk series punya element, which is REQ and J and XEQ ni, series impedances we can determine by using short circuit test. So in short circuit test, what we do is we short circuit the secondary side, which is the load side, like this. Kita sambung saja, kita short circuitkan dia. Okay, this is the circuit configuration of the short circuit test of the transformer to determine the series impedances of the model. What we do here, kita adjust voltage dia. Kita adjust voltage sehinggalah current. Sehinggalah current ni sama dengan rated current of the primary side of the transformer. Okay, sama dengan dia punya rated value. Rated value ni sebenarnya kita boleh dapat daripada transformer, dia ada rated value dia. Macam device yang lain juga, dia ada rated current, rated voltage kan. So, kita tahu rated value of the current of that transformer. What we do here in that experiment is we adjust the voltage until we get the current through this emitter is the same as the value of the rated current of the transformer. Bila dah sampai current tu sama dengan rated value of the current of the transformer, masa itulah kita buat measurement lah. Kita record value VSC, voltage, short circuit voltage, short circuit current, ISC and power, PSC. Okay, so we get the value of VSC, ISC and power, PSC. Then in this case, when we short circuit here, apa yang berlaku sebenarnya, dia punya parallel branch ni punya effect can be ignored. Maksudnya, effective voltage drop now happen at the series impedance saja. Okay? voltage drop berlaku dekat series impedance sahaja when we do short circuit of the transformer. So maksudnya kita boleh buat measurement of the series impedance lah. Okay. So kita dah ada VSC, ISC ni kita boleh calculate ZSE. Okay. Simbol dia guna ZSE ya. ZSE. So ZSE, begitu juga dengan power factor. So we can calculate power factor because we already have the PSC, VSC and ISC. We can calculate the power factor which is cosine theta. So from that cosine theta, okay, from that cosine theta, we can determine ZSE lah. Okay, so kita dapat lah VSC bagi dengan ISC. Semua value ni dah ada. Then put the theta in degree. And then once we get that ZSE ni, kita boleh further extend. Because ni dalam bentuk polar kan? Ni dalam bentuk polar. So we can convert this to rectangular form like this. Okay, daripada polar convert kepada rectangular form. Supaya kita dapat REQ and JEQ. Okay, kita dapat REQ and JEQ. Okay, dan apabila diberi turns ratio, bila diberikan turns ratio, kita boleh further calculate the series and parallel resistances and also the series and parallel reactances. Okay. So, itu secara teori ya. Mungkin susah nak faham kan? Secara teori, explanation about how we can use the short circuit test and also the open circuit test to determine the values of the transformer equivalent circuit. For example, let's say if we want to determine the approximate equivalent circuit of this approximate equivalent circuit of the transformer, what we do is to conduct the short circuit test and open circuit test to determine the values of REQ, XEQ, RC and XM ini. Okay. So that is about the determine the value of the transformer model. Okay. So kalau sempat habis sesi ini, saya akan pergi kepada video perbincangan berkenaan dengan tutorial 2.2 itu ya. Okay. So next is about the per unit system of measurement. Per unit system of measurement. Saya tak tunjuk tadi saya punya notes ah. Lecture notes ada kat sini. Nanti saya share. Saya dah share dah pun dalam saya punya tu kan. Tapi in order for you to get the latest version, sebab masa sesi kuliah saya conteng-conteng eh. Nanti from time to time you keep download the new one lah. Saya akan update yang new one nanti. Nanti you boleh download the new one. Okay, yang ni yang tadilah nota berkenaan dengan section tadi. Determine the values of the transformer model tu. Okay, explanation benda yang sama. Full line voltage apply and then and finally. Ini ringkasan lah saya tulis ya. Procedure untuk open circuit ni. Kita buat open circuit test untuk measure VOC, IOC, POC. Dan daripada VOC, IOC, POC itu kita calculate cosine theta. Okay, cosine theta adalah power factor. So, kita dapat semua value ni. Daripada value ni, kita determine the YE which is admittance. Ha? Kita determine the admittance. Admittance tu dia represent in terms of polar form like this. Okay. So, kita convert lah daripada polar form tu kepada rectangular form yang mengandungi complex number kan. So, dapat YE in terms of rectangular form like this. Then, daripada rectangular form itu, kita boleh determine G, conductance dan juga susceptance. Eh, satu 1 over XM ni susceptance. So, daripada situlah kita boleh determine RC dengan XM, which is the parallel branch lah. Okay, jadi parallel branch lah. RC sini, XM sini kan. Okay, itu kaedah open circuit lah. So, short circuit, kita shortkan. Okay. And then kita supply adjust voltage supaya current dia sama dengan current rated voltage value, rated value of the transformer punya current. Rated value to the high voltage side ataupun primary side of the transformer. To adjust supaya kita, we want to make sure that current is flowing through this short circuit. Maksudnya current tu akan mengalir melalui ni. Parallel branch, current tu tak lalu dah. Current tak cross ikut parallel branch. That's why kita adjust voltage tu. Supaya rated value current ni sama dengan rated value transformer. Current yang dapat ni sama dengan rated value transformer. Supaya current tu melalui kawasan yang short ni saja. So, pada masa tu, kita determine lah. Dia punya VSC, ISC and PSC. And then also theta. And then, we determine the impedance, series impedance menggunakan value tadi. Dan bila kita dapat series impedance ni, series impedance ni sebenarnya dalam bentuk apa nama ni, polar form lah. Ini dalam bentuk polar form lah. Ini dalam bentuk polar form. And then, daripada polar form ni kita convert lah kepada rectangular form yang ada imaginary values ni kan. Daripada situ kita dah pecah, baru kita dapat nilai-nilai REQ, SEQ, okay. Itu daripada nota tu lah. Sekarang ni saya nak pergi kepada per unit system of measurement. Okay, per unit system of measurement ini, it is the way that we can eliminate the referring method. Sebelum ni kita menggunakan referring method. For example, if you see here, kita menggunakan referring method. Maknanya, yang ni circuit referring to the primary side. Yang B ni pula circuit referring to the secondary side, right? So, we want to eliminate the method of using referring method, which is based on the A, which is the transformer punya turns ratio. So, we want to eliminate that sort of tedious. Maksudnya, calculation menggunakan banyak-banyak benda nak kena calculate kan. So, kita buat macam mana? Kita menggunakan the per unit system of measurement. Okay, we use the per unit system of the measurement to eliminate the tedious work. Kalau nak tahu, boleh refer kepada example 2.1 tutorial. Boleh follow tutorial 2.1. Saya ada tunjukkan macam mana kita nak selesaikan problem tu. Menggunakan kaedah yang konvensyen, yang lama lah, tanpa menggunakan per unit system. So, daripada situ pun, video tu boleh tengok lah. Hampir sejam juga. Saya ambil masa untuk saya selesaikan problem tu. So, maknanya banyak calculation berlaku kat situ. So, in that case, since we use the traditional method, that is using the referring method, we want to eliminate such calculation lah menggunakan per unit system. Okay? So, in per unit system, what we basically do is actually kita menggunakan quantity sebagai reference. Quantity sebagai reference, which is we call it as the base value ataupun base quantity lah. Kita menggunakan base quantity untuk sebagai reference lah, sebagai reference untuk determine dia punya per unit quantity. Okay, so maksudnya kat sini per unit quantity adalah actual value divided by base value quantity. Okay. So biasanya kita pilih normally what we choose for our base value is sama ada P base, Q base or S base that represents power and also V base. Okay, sama ada voltage ataupun power. Biasanya kita pilih voltage ataupun power as base value. Power tu tak kira lah sama ada P base ataupun Q base ataupun S base. Kenapa ada P, Q, S ni? Tu kena berbalik kepada power dalam power system lah. Power ni dia ada apparent power, active power and reactive power kan. Okay. Bila melibatkan inductance ataupun coil ke apa, motor lah contohnya kan. So, power quantity dia dalam bentuk S, dalam bentuk apparent power. Because when we operate the motor, there is some inductive element that becomes imaginary. Inductive element becomes imaginary. Kalau tengok kat sini, kan, bahagian ni, ini inductive element lah. Inductive element yang menjadi imaginary. Okay. Resistive element tak apa. Tak ada masalah. Dia tak melibatkan lagging or lagging lah biasanya untuk inductance. Kalau untuk capacitor, dia akan leading. Okay. Power factor dia lari lah. Maksudnya ada some degree of shift between voltage and current. Okay. So, dalam kes ni kita menggunakan S-base lah biasanya untuk transformer menggunakan S-base. Okay. So basically, we can use V-base to determine Z-base. Mula-mula kita dapatkan, saya tunjukkan nota ni lah. Okay, for per unit system, we compare the actual value to the base value lah. Base value, we normally choose base value, voltage dengan power. Biasanya kita pilih voltage dengan power lah as a base value. So that bila kita dah ada voltage, kita dah ada power, kita boleh determine current. Okay, bila kita ada voltage, bila kita ada voltage, ada power, kita boleh determine I base dulu. Itu base value saja, I base dulu. And then, daripada situ, daripada I base itu, kita boleh determine Z base. Z base, menggunakan I base tadi yang kita dapat daripada power dan voltage itu, kita boleh determine dah Z base using this equation. And then, so kita dah ada lah Z base, I base, V base, P base, semua dah ada. Then, oh tak ada dah. Sekejap. Mana dah ni? Okay. So, kita dah determine dah. Semua value tu, kita semua dah ada base quantity lah. Bila kita dah dapat base quantity, barulah kita boleh determine dia punya per unit value. Okay. Kena refer soalan ni sebenarnya. By contoh ni lagi senang lah. Faham lah. Okay. So, basically, theoretical explanation is like that. So, firstly, what we do is to choose the voltage base and also power base. Then, from voltage base and power base, we determine the current. From current, we can determine the impedance, which is Z base. Current ada, kita boleh calculate Z base lah. Ataupun, kita boleh calculate admittance, terbalik kepada impedance tadi. The inverse of the impedance is admittance. Dan juga kita boleh menggunakan formula yang menggunakan V square divided by S base. Kalau formula ni menggunakan S base. Okay. So, daripada situ kita dah determine semualah. Z base ada, I base ada, V base ada, S base pun ada. So, daripada situ kita dah ada base value. Then, we can determine the per unit quantity lah. Menggunakan base tadi. Contohnya, kita nak dapatkan primary side punya per unit power. Per unit power. Kita menggunakan S-base. S-base lah. Kita gunakan S-base. Dan actual value of the power tadi, kita divided by S-base. Baru dapat dia punya per unit value. gitulah seterusnya untuk voltage dan juga current. Okay, so why we choose power? Okay, why we choose power? Okay, biasa kita menggunakan power kan? Kenapa? Why we choose power? Power ni dia tak beri kesan walaupun ada turns ratio ke. Power input sama dengan power output. So power at the input is always the same as the power at the output. That is why we choose power. Okay? So we choose power for easier calculation lah because power input is sama dengan power output of the transformer. Kalau voltage base ni, V base change according to the turns ratio. Okay? Voltage bergantung kepada turns ratio. Eh? Maknanya VP equals to AVS kan? So, dia bergantung kepada turns ratio. That is why we use P base and V base. Dua-dua ni already cover the referring method lah. So, bila kita guna dua-dua ni, we have already eliminate the need for using traditional approach of referring method in calculating the transformer value. Okay, so that is the explanation about per unit. Then akhir sekali 2.7 ni voltage regulation. Untuk voltage regulation, ini sebenarnya transformer dia ada primary side and the secondary side. What we do is normally at the secondary side we apply load. Kita sambungkan load pada secondary side. Okay, which is VS lah, source side. Source side ataupun secondary side. Apabila kita apply full load, dia akan berlaku voltage drop. Okay, bila kita apply full load, dia akan berlaku voltage drop at the secondary side of the transformer. Let's say this is the primary side. We supply with the voltage. Then secondary side ini kita sambung dengan load kan? Kita sambung dengan load. So voltage at the secondary side ini depends on load. Maknanya kalau load tu kita increasekan load, maknanya akan berlaku voltage drop. Voltage drop. Maknanya VS ni drop. Okay? So di situlah perlunya voltage regulation yang mana kita adjust voltage kat sini supaya kita boleh overcome the voltage drop. Kita boleh compensate lah, kita panggil. Saya gunakan istilah compensate for the voltage drop at the secondary side. So, to calculate the voltage regulation, VR. So, it is basically voltage at the secondary side, VS, with at no load. Masa tak ada load, minus voltage at the secondary side at full load. Full load bahagi dengan voltage at the secondary side at full load. Then darab dengan 100% lah. So VR is in percent. VR is in percent. Okay. Let's say at no load, transformer tu dia ada conversion kan? Referring method tu kan? So VP is AVS. Then we can just use further extend this equation. Apabila kita substitute VS ini, okay, kita substitute VS, kita dapatlah VP over A minus VS full load divided by VS full load. Sekiranya diberi VP dengan A, so kita boleh menggunakan equation ni lah. And then in per unit juga voltage regulation sama juga. Kalau transformer itu problem dia diberikan dalam per unit, so then we can use VPPU minus VS full load per unit divided by VS full load per unit. Okay. Sekejap, saya cross check je dengan textbook ah. Ini soalan tadi. Voltage regulation. VPPU minus VS full load per unit divided by VS full load per unit. Eh. Dia menggunakan VP per unit. Eh. VP per unit. Okay. So, VP per unit minus VS full load per unit divided by VS full load per unit. Itu formula dia. So, in ideal transformer, of course, the voltage regulation or VR is 0%, which is in ideal transformer, we made some assumption which is no loss that occurs in the ideal transformer. That is why for the ideal transformer, normally VR is 0%. No voltage drop at the secondary. Okay. And then finally, this section, this final slide, which is about voltage, so about transformer efficiency. So, when we talk about efficiency, meaning that we take the output power divided by input power times 100% lah. So, we got the efficiency of the transformer. So, biasanya soalan sebenarnya daripada VR ini terus saja kita diminta untuk dapatkan dia punya efficiency lah. So, basically Pin ini bergantung kepada Ploss. Okay, bergantung kepada Ploss. So, we can further extend this equation, which is denominator tu kita represented by Pout plus Ploss lah. And then, loss in transformer is basically based on the copper loss, hysteresis and eddy current losses. For example, if we want to extend more this part of the equation, so Ploss ni maksudnya copper loss, core loss. Okay. Yang ni adalah Pout lah. VSIS cosine theta tu adalah Pout. So, itu slides berkenaan dengan itu adalah explanation, discussion on the transformer open circuit and short circuit test, and then voltage regulation, and also the per unit system measurement of the transformer. Okay, so sebelum habis, saya nak